Hello students, today we are going to start our third poem. It is 2.3, The Inchcape Rock, which is written by a great poet Robert Southey. So it is the first part of our third poem 2.3, The Inchcape Rock. In this first part, we are going to learn the information given about the poet and little bit information given about this poem here. So, open your book, page number 104. Now listen carefully. Robert Southey, 1774 to 1843. It means Robert Southey was born in 1774 and he died in 1843. He was born in Bristol, England. So there was a place or a town or a city in England, Bristol. In that place, in that town, Robert Southey was born. He was the son of a draper. See the meaning of this word, draper. Draper, it means the one who sells cloths. So any person who sells cloth, that person is called draper. Educated at Westminster School, Balliol College, Oxford. Now he had got education from a Westminster School and after that a Balliol College from the Oxford University. He was a poet laureate. Laureate, what is the meaning of laureate? Poet laureate. Poet laureate means an honor of royal poet in England. He was a poet laureate of England from 1813 to 1843. So in this period, from 1813 to 1843, Robert Southey was a royal poet. He had an honor of royal poet in England during this period, 1813 to 1843. Some of his short poems like The Scholar, The Ballad of Bellingham, Bishop Hatto, The Inchcape Rock, etc. are very popular with the school children. Now here are given some kind of information about Robert Southey's very famous poems, which are very famous in particularly in school children. The one is The Scholar. This is the one poem. Second poem, The Ballad of Bellingham. Third poem, Bishop Hatto. Fourth poem, The Inchcape Rock. And there are many other poems also, but here are given only four, name of only four poems. The Inchcape Rock is a ballad. Now here we are getting information about this poem, Inchcape Rock, which we are going to learn in this lesson or in this book. The Inchcape Rock is a ballad. So what is the meaning of ballad? Look at here. ballad. It means a poem. Narrating a popular story in short stanzas. The Inchcape Rock. So, what is the meaning of Inchcape Rock? First of all, we have to know about it. So, Inchcape, it means a bell. Look at the page number 105. There is given a picture of a bell. So this kind of bell is called Inchcape, and the title of the poem is The Inchcape Rock. It means bell, rock of lighthouse. So what is the meaning of lighthouse? Lighthouse, it is a tower built near the coastal area in the sea or in the ocean to show direction to the ships, to show ships that there is near a coastal area. That kind of pillar where is hang or put a light, that long pillar which is set in the sea water or in the ocean water, that is called lighthouse. But in a lighthouse which is made by the rock, so that lighthouse is called rock lighthouse. And in the ancient time there was no light, so people were using bell to show as a sign if there is any kind of danger. If anyone rang the bell, it means the sailor who is sailing his ship understood that there is some kind of danger. In modern time, on these kind of towers we can see a light, a red color light, but in the ancient time there were no lights, so people were using bell. The Inchcape Rock, it means the bell rock of lighthouse. There was a lighthouse and there is bell on that lighthouse, and that lighthouse is made by rock, that is not made by cement concrete, that is made by rock, that is made naturally there in the sea. The Inchcape Rock is a ballad. Now this poem we are going to learn, the Inchcape Rock, it is a ballad. It means it is a poem narrating a popular story in short stanzas. Ballad, it means a poem which narrate a very popular story, any story, in very short stanzas, very clearly, and give us deep information about that story. It's the story of the 14th century attempt by the abbot. See the meaning of this word, abbot. Abbot, it means the head of abbey. So what is the meaning of abbey? It means house of monks. So what is the meaning of monks? Look at here. Monks, it means the member. the member of religious community. It's the story of the 14th century attempt by the abbot of Aberbrothok to install a warning bell on Inchcape. Inchcape, it is a natural rock in the sea or in the ocean water where is we can see some kind of a bell is hanged. Bell on Inchcape, the notorious ridge of rock near the surface of the sea water. So what is the meaning of ridge? So there was an abbot, and name of that abbot is Aberbrothok. He wanted to install a bell on a Inchcape. Inchcape, it means a rock, natural rock, which is raised up in the seawater or ocean water. So on that Inchcape, an abbot, he was a very religious person, abbot, and name of that person is Aberbrothok, wanted to set a bell on that Inchcape. And that Inchcape was very notorious. That area, that Inchcape was very notorious. It means it was infamous, wicked. There were happening some criminal activities, and that Inchcape was made by sandstone. Sandstone, it means particularly from many years the sand was collecting there, and after that that was compressed, and by this the rock set there. The reef about 11 miles, it means 18 kilometers of the east coast of Angle. So that reef, it means the top of that Inchcape was about 11 miles, it means 80 kilometers away from the coastal area of that Scotland, which was near the Dundee and Fife, which was occupied by the Belrock Lighthouse. Southey was inspired by the legendary story. See the meaning of this word. Let me first clean this slide. Legendary, it means described in legend.
So what is the meaning of legend?
Legend, it means a traditional story inspired by the legendary story of a pirate. Pirate, see the meaning of this word. Pirate, it means sea robber. Who removed the bell on the inch cap rock placed by the abbot of Aberbrothok. Now, this story is about a monk, a religious person, and abbot, and name of that abbot is Aberbrothok. Aberbrothok placed a bell on the inch cap rock, and there was a pirate, a sea robber, who removed that bell from that inch cap rock. And our poet Robert Southey was very inspired by this story, and therefore he had written this ballad for our study. The poem gives us a message that those who do wrong things will meet due punishment. See the meaning of this word, due. Due, it means expected or deserving. Or another meaning is proper. So through this ballad, through this story, we are going to learn. There is given a very beautiful message for all of us. If anybody is doing wrong, anybody is doing wrong things in his life, so he will get the proper punishment himself by his act. In this way, we have completed the information about the poet and the poem in this part here. So today we are going to stop here. Thank you very much. Have a good day to all of you.